see you again. Please take a seat, relax, make yourself at home as usual. So today's a bit of a special day. It's actually our 1 month anniversary. That's right, it's been 1 month since we started having these one-to-one sessions, and I sincerely hope that you've been getting something from them and that it's been helping you to relax, maybe focus more, and just get more out of your day-to-day life. So today's session is going to be a little bit different. We're not going to use a stone. We are just going to use my mitts and your mind. And what I mean by that is that today we're actually going to be performing a guided, structured meditation following a general tune-up of Reiki and your ethereal energy. So I'm just, as usual, just going to start by gently stroking through your ethereal body, your energy, and everything else. And I wanted to start today as well by talking to you about what you want. The point of this session isn't just to assess your ethereal body, but it's also to work out where you've been, where you are, and where you'd like to go. So, firstly, as I said, I hope that these sessions have been relaxing for you and that they are helping you to sleep. And with a relaxed mind comes clearer thinking about where you want to be. And people have said to me before, Jimmy, how come you knew what you wanted to do? How come you knew you wanted to do all this Reiki mumbo jumbo? And it's easy for me. Sometimes, obviously, for some people, you just know what you want to do, and that's fine, but some people don't. And if you need a bit of extra help working out what you'd like to do, or working out where you want to go, that's easy. There's a little test that I sometimes like to do with myself, where you imagine for 1 second that you don't have to worry about money anymore. Forget about money. Forget about it, okay? Basically, you've got unlimited money. You don't need to worry about it ever again, okay? Now, what would you do with your time if you didn't have to worry about earning money? You didn't have to worry about rent. You didn't have to worry about medical bills. You didn't have to worry about buying groceries, whatever. What would you do if you didn't have to do anything? And often what I find is that when people answer that question, they actually answer with what they should be doing, not what they would be doing. So you might think to yourself, oh, if I didn't have to worry about earning bucks every day, I would just open a bar, or I would become an artist, anything like that. And that answer is the thing that you probably should be concentrating on. Your passions. The things that you would do with your time if you had a little bit more of it. A little bit more time. What would you do with it? And that is what you should do. So when you think about where you are, where you've been, and when you want to think about where you want to go, consider where you would go if you didn't have to go anywhere. Am I making sense? I know it's a little bit silly sounding, but I found that this train of thought, this way of thinking, can help you really understand what you want to do in your life. Because it's difficult to choose. And sometimes you feel like if you choose, that door closes, slams shut in your face, and you can never go back. But that's not true. You can go back. You can always change your mind. And people tend to give themselves a hard time about changing their minds when they don't need to at all. It's okay to change your mind. It's okay to change your opinion. It's okay to change opinions like it is to change clothes. As long as you're not hurting anyone, it doesn't matter. So give yourself a break. Relax. And just try to work out where you want to go. Where your best self deserves to go. Okay. Now let's just take, I did a little bit of energy pulling there, but let's take a proper look. Okay? So I'm just going to get in a little closer. Just do a bit of palpation around your face to see what we're dealing with. Okay? Okay. Good. That's looking nice. It's looking very smooth today. I hope you've been sleeping well. And how's your week been? Yeah? Well, we can't always live for the weekend. We have to learn to live for the weekdays too, even if they can be a little bit stressful or a little bit annoying sometimes. Okay, so what we got here is a bit of tension around the brow, around the jaw here, and actually under your jaw, under your chin. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to work from the top around, and we're going to see where we're at. After that, we'll do some guided meditation to help you relax, okay? So, we got two knots, one here, one here. So I'm just going to concentrate on this one first. This one's doing here. Let's get rid of this right away. Okay, good. And same with this one. But this one's a bit easier. Okay. Ah, there we go. And down here, on the right hand side of your jaw. Oh, that was easy. Get rid of that at the left-hand side. Okay, there we go. Nice and easy. And under your chin, tickle, tickle, there was a little one. So that's not so bad. Yeah, easy. Now, what tends to happen is when we unlock blocks like those, or unwind them, or comb them out, whatever, then strands of energy pour out. And that's when we just very easily pull out residual, unnecessary energy. Okay, here we go. Easy, easy, easy. So because this part isn't so difficult, and it's not so strenuous, all you need to do is relax. We'll try some guided meditation to help you get a good night's sleep, okay? So, first of all, I want you to breathe in for three, and then breathe out for three. So in, one, two, three, and hold, two, three, and out, two, three. Let's do it together. In. Easy. That was easy. Okay. And so, what we are doing now is I would like you to relax and imagine that you're lying down in a safe place. And that safe place can be wherever you like. It can be inside a deep woodland crevice, or it can be in the back seat of your favorite car, just having a doze, or even your bed. All that I will say is that you should be on your own. You should feel completely safe in this place, all on your own, okay? Now, as you relax into this place and listen to the sounds around you, whatever those relaxing sounds may be, I want you to tense the lower half of your body, so your feet and your legs. So just focus on your feet and your legs. And as you focus, you realize that your feet are becoming very relaxed, very relaxed. Like there's no weight in them at all. Like you're floating. And this floating feeling, this feeling of complete relaxation, slowly moves up your legs. And your legs feel smooth and relaxed. And this feeling then moves gently up to your waist and envelops the area. And you feel very sluggish and relaxed. And then this feeling moves gently up again to your stomach, to your diaphragm. And you can feel your diaphragm gently relax. And you realize that with each breath in and out, your diaphragm and your stomach area becomes even more relaxed. Your chest, heavy at first, starts to fall and relax. Your breathing becomes softer, more regular, and eventually just becomes automatic. You just stop paying attention to it until this feeling of overwhelming relaxation reaches your shoulders. And where there was tension, where there was stress, it floats away. And the feeling, this warm feeling, almost like warm water, as you're being submerged into it, flows down your arms. And they relax all the way to the tips of your digits. Your fingers just start to melt with relaxation. Until this overwhelming feeling of complete peace reaches your head. And then this peace melts down your entire body. Just flows down your body, straight through your entire body, down and out through your toes. And, well, by this time, you can pretty much just go to sleep. So you're feeling very relaxed, very docile and lethargic, but comfortably so. And you concentrate on your breathing again, which is being very regular. In, out, from your diaphragm, in, out. Now I want you to imagine that relaxing place again. And you're just lying there, melting into the surroundings. Just becoming part of the furniture. And now you can see where you've been, where you are, and where you're going. It's clear now. With a clear, calm mind, you can better examine not just your surroundings, but internally as well. You can see things you've done, things you are doing, and things that you're going to do. And for you, this makes it clearer. It makes it clearer about what you want to do as well. take a moment to think about that while I just place my hands over your eyes and count to 10, okay? So hold on, don't worry. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And there we go. Easy. Now there's a through flow of energy. How are you feeling? That's the first guided meditation I've actually done, so I hope that it wasn't too quick. Feel free to give me feedback to let me know if I can improve it. I just want you to be able to relax as much as possible when you're here, okay? Now, just before we finish, I am going to do a little massage, okay? A little bit of a short session today, but we'll pick up where we left next week with another crystal, and hopefully you'll be able to relax, and when I see you next week, you'll feel very clear-headed and might have a better idea about what you want to do.